you don't even know who you are. Who are the sons of God? And the Bible, very clear, very explicit on this topic. Because you have to be, you have to qualify. It's not everybody that says, Lord, 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 that is the son of the Lord. It's not everybody, even Jesus Christ said so. He said, on that day, many will say, Jesus, Lord, Lord, we serve you, we cast out devils. He said, he will tell them, get out from me, I know you not. May that not be your portion.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. You will know who you are. And when you know who you are, nobody can lie to you. When you know who you are, nobody can diminish you. When you know who you are, nobody can humiliate you. Now, even when life treats you roughly, you will still know that you are the child of the King. And it's only a matter of time. It's only a matter of time. It's only a matter of time. I've been sent to you by the Almighty God that you should hang on. Don't compromise. Hang on. God is coming for you.
Amen.
And you will be so glad you did. In the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit of the living God, here is your word. The word is God. And the word is incubated with power. Lord God Almighty, anyone tonight that may suffer from identity crisis, that may suffer from low self-esteem, that may suffer from insecurities, that may suffer, oh God, not from any dysfunction in their mind, oh God, arrest it by the mighty power that is in the name of Jesus. I release the power of God into the atmosphere. Lord, let there be the hearing of your word. And let your word transform one of us in the name of Jesus. Let your word heal us. Let your word deliver us. Let your word empower us. And Lord, let us be lifted to now by the power that is in the name of Jesus. I give you glory and honor in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
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 Turn with me to Galatians chapter 4. I'm going to be teaching tonight, so you need your Bible, you need a note. You need to listen carefully. Galatians chapter 4, verse 5. The title of our message tonight is Who Are the Sons of God? Verse 5, it says, let me start from verse 4. It says, for when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your heart, crying, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but you are a son. And if you are a son, then an heir of God through Christ. You are no longer a slave. You are a son of God.
Amen.
And it's not blasphemy. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2 that Jesus did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. But he was equal with God, yet he submitted to the authority of the Father. But what I love most in this scripture is what was in verse 4. It says, when the fullness of time has come, in this season of this conference, the fullness of your time has come. The fullness of your time has come. Look, when you see a woman who is pregnant, at the fullness of time, she cannot be held back. You will see a woman cute, she can stroll like this into the hospital. When that time comes, nothing can hold her. The baby must come. But I come to announce to you by the power of the Holy Spirit that in heaven right now, the womb of God has dilated. The womb of God is releasing you. The fullness of time has come for your manifestation. And as God pushes you out, nothing can stop you. Nothing will withhold you in the name of Jesus. Shout, say, my time has come. Shout, say, my time has come. It's the fullness of time. When that happens, that is it. The most dangerous human being on earth was not, it's not Boko Haram. It's not Al-Qaeda. The most dangerous person on earth is not the terrorist. The most dangerous human being on earth is the man or the woman whose time has come. Because when your time has come, heaven's back you. You need to know you cannot be limited. You need to know that the power of your mighty God is available to you. The Bible says of David, he said the prophet Nathan told David, he said, God is with you. He said, whatever is in your heart to do, do it. God is with you. I wish I had somebody to believe that. God is with you. Whatever is in your heart to do, do it. God is with you. Don't let anybody tell you, oh, you are too old to study, you are too female, you are too black. All of those things are advantages that make you peculiar. You are peculiar. You are unique. You are wonderfully and fearfully made. There is no other person like you. God looked at you. He said, you are good. That's all that matters. Once God approves you, nobody can disappoint you. Every disappointment in your life, I command it to be turned to this appointment in the name of Jesus. This appointment in the name of Jesus. Shall I say my time has come? That we are joint heirs. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are joint heirs. In other words, all your children are all the same. All your children, the same. Whatever both of you own, they own it. All the same. All the same. And the Bible is assuring us that we are joint heirs with Jesus. The Bible says in 1 John 4 that as he is, so are we in this world. As he is, as Jesus is today, so are we in this world. How is he today? Exalted. Yeah. Above all powers. Exalted above darkness. Yeah. He's ruling. He's seated at the right hand side of the Father. Oh. He's at rest. Yeah. He is decreeing and declaring, and it must be. Yeah. Now, let me tell you something about being a heir. For you to be a heir, my background was in law. And there is something that you write a testament to bequeath something to somebody. So if I write a will now and say everything I own goes to my daughter, until I die, she cannot receive it. If she comes to me while I'm alive and says, this is the will that she wrote, can I have it? I'm going to go into the closet and say, God, arrest this child. Because I'm not dead yet. How many people are with me so far? Now, God called us heirs. Now, our God, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he came, born of a woman. He died. He died. How many people don't know what happened when he died? Now, I hate it when I go to those religious churches and they say, this person you die, that person fall down and die, this person fall down and die. I say, oh, when your enemy dies, their intention will come to pass. You will inherit it by will. It's better for your enemies not to die. It's better for them to be alive. It's better for them to be paralyzed. It's better for them to see what God will do. Jesus. We are heirs of salvation. But look at us in America. We don't walk as heirs of salvation. We don't walk as heirs of Jesus. All of us who don't have papers, we hear the police coming. Our hearts beat. But this is not coming for you. You already died before they even. Tell your neighbor, she's talking about you.
Don't let offense cause you to stumble. Don't let God
gossips in church cause you to stumble. Don't let what people, some members are in church, they don't want to go to heaven.
Yeah.
They were assigned to church to make sure that you don't go.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's true.
So all you do is look in your eye and they say, oh, do you know Pastor was my oldest sister is a doctor. She's in our church. She sits under my anointing. And one day I was preaching. I said that God said he preferred Jacob from the womb. The younger shall rule the old. They went to go and tell my sister. They said, Pastor was talking about you. You know, she said she was young and she must rule over you before. I said, yeah. But my sister came and told me. I said, is it in your Bible what I read? Sister, what do you want me to apologize about? Is it in your Bible? Have you not known me from the day I was born? You are 10 years older than me. When they said that to you, what did you say? Let today be the last day. You will come and tell me somebody said I said something about you. I swear to God, nobody will hold me back. She backed off fast. She backed off. Because my apostolic anointing came up. If I didn't handle it like that, she too will go home like, oh, she abused me. I didn't even think about her. It didn't even cross my mind. I was just reading the scripture. But there are bad people in church.
Yeah.
I've met more bad people in church than when I was a sinner.
Yeah.
You have to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. If you talk about the man of God, leprosy will come upon you. No, but it's not a curse. Miriam did it to Moses. She became leprous. Do not touch the anointing and do the prophet of God no harm. Don't talk about the man of God. Don't talk about his wife. Don't talk about their children. They're sacred. If they offend you, report them to the boss. And therefore, handle it. But the sign of the sonship is that God can correct you. John, chapter 1, the Gospel of John, the big John. Chapter 1. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are my helper. You are my God. Holy Spirit. John, chapter 1, verse 12. He says, for as many as received him, to them he gave us all rights to become children of God. And to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, not of the will of man, but they were born of God. How many people have that in your Bible? It's there. We are born of God. And the Lord says he has given you authority to be called the Son of God. Now, if God has given you authority, who can come against the authority of God? Lamentations chapter 3, verse 27. He said, who is it that has spoken when the Lord has not commanded it? And anything that the enemy has spoken over your life that has not been commanded by God, I command it to be impotent to now. And come on to pass to now. Every curse against your life, every voodoo, every spell, every hex, every control, every manipulation, every juju that anyone has done, I render it impotent. I paralyze it by the power that is in the If it is not of God, you will not prosper. In the name of Jesus. You have the authority. That's what this word just said. You have the authority to be the child of God. And let me tell you, church, anytime I find anything in the Bible, I scratch out and I put my name there. Authority for me to be a son of God. You cannot change my mind. That's why you must read your Bible. You cannot leave your Bible in the car on Sunday night, and then when you're coming for midweek, you go and dust it and quickly bring it to church. It doesn't work. You must read your Bible daily, because that is the word of God and the authority that makes us to be who we are. And when you know who you are, nobody can mess with you.
Yes.
Let tonight be the last night that you are distressed by the devil. In the name of Jesus. We are the sons of God. We have authority from heaven. And once God gives his authority, it cannot be reversed. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 24 and 25. He says, well, God has determined, it cannot be annulled. Let the plans and the purpose of God for your life manifest.
Amen.
I loose it in the name of Jesus. I command the manifestation in the name of Jesus. The perfect plan of God. Jeremiah 29:11, it says the thoughts of God towards you are thoughts of good and not of evil.
Yes.
To bring you to an expected end.
Yes.
That thought of God, I command it to manifest. I command it to push you to the expected end of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It will be so. By the power that is in the name of Jesus, we have the authority. It doesn't belong to the rich. It doesn't belong to the brilliant. It doesn't belong. Look, let me tell you something. God has a sense of humor. In my family, I have a PhD. But I have a PhD where nobody expected it. Everybody, they're brilliant. They've gone to Harvard. They've gone to this place. Me, when my parents asked me, do you want to go to school? I said, no, sir. You don't want to go to school? I said, no. What do you want to do? I said, I want to marry. My mother, I said, I want to marry, and I don't want to waste your money. I want to marry, and I want to have 20 children. I want to marry a pastor, and I want to have 20 children. And I'm going to have a boss, and I'll drive them to church, and I'll drive them to the My mother said, I don't think men like illiterate women. That's my mother. She's an iron lady, Margaret Thatcher. And she said to me, hey, so you don't want to go to school, right? So when the husband comes home, how are you going to entertain your friends, Mrs. Dollard? I said, oh. I said, okay, maybe I may have one first degree. So for me, they pushed me, they begged me, they pushed me, they begged me, they pushed me. My father was my favorite. I was a daddy's girl. Come on, mom. You can look at her and she just slap you. That what I mean. She's like an octopus. She can beat 10 people simultaneously. I don't know how she does it. I went to college one time and I came back, told her. My mother was saying, I'm like, this woman is this short. She saw me looking, she said, what are you looking at? I said, because she can never know what the right answer is with my mother. But my dad, perfect gentleman. Cambridge scholar, erudite, beautiful man. He doesn't beat me, maybe once, but not often. I was like my mom. She would beat me just because my dad didn't beat me. So whatever I missed, I balanced it here somewhere. It was always like that. So I was more like my dad, more like my dad, more like my dad. And then my dad said to me, he said he will please me if you go to college. He said, because it's in you. You are brilliant. You just don't want to do anything. I said, well, please, you sure? I went to school, cleared my fourth degree, cleared two masters, did a PhD. Yeah. My mother was like, what happened? Where are the other 19 children? Because you have one now, and you can't find the other 19. But glory be to God, in every nation where I go now, God raises his son. So be need a familiar spirit. This is not about family. We have people from Guyana, people from Malawi, people from America, people from Nigeria, and people Sierra Leone, Cameroon, all the nations are present. Why? Because God has something He wants to do through you and me. And whatever God has marked to do through you, nothing will abort it.
Yes.
You will not be aborted. You will not be stopped in the name of Jesus. You will not be miscarried.
No.
You will fulfill your purpose. You will fulfill your days.
Yes.
And the power that is in the name of Jesus. Who are the sons of God? Let's look in Romans chapter 8, our text.